हेलो बच्चा पार्टी, वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल। आई होप यू हैव वॉच द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स इन चैप्टर 4। नाउ दिस इज द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट एडिशन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन, सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन एंड डिविजन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द एडिशन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन, हाउ टू एड फ्रैक्शन, in which there are different types. Let's study one by one. Let's start with the type 1, that is when a denominator of fraction are same. Let's take an example. If you have given denominator as 1 upon 4 plus 2 upon 4, here you can see that both the denominators are 4. It is the simplest addition of a fraction where both the denominator are same. So in that case, you have to write denominator as it is. This is only when denominator are same. You have to write denominator as it is. And for numerator, you have to just add both the numerator. You have to just add both the numerator. That is 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. So 3 by 4 is your answer. Is it simple or not? It is very simple. But in some case, for example, if I add 1 upon 6 plus 2 upon 6. Here also, both the denominator are same. That is 6 and 6. So, for that, we have to write denominator as 6 only. But in numerator, we have to add both the numerator, that is 1 plus 2, 3. Now here, as you can see, 3 and 6. Does this fraction has simplest form? We have learned in the part 1, when numerator, either denominator, one of them are coming in each other tables. For this example, 3 and 6, both are coming in table of 3. 3 ones are and 6, 3, 2's are. So the simplest form of 3 by 6 is 1 by 2. So the answer of your this addition is 1 by 2. So you have to remember this. When you are adding the fraction, then you get the particular fraction. You have to look whether the simplest form of that fraction is possible or not. If possible, you have to write the simplest form for given fraction. If not, in this case, it is not possible for us to find the simplest form. As you can see, neither of them are coming in the same table. Okay? So, in this example, 3 and 6 both are coming in the table of 3. That's why 3 ones are 3 and 3 twos are 6. So, the simplest form for 3 by 6 is 1 by 2. And the answer for addition is also 1 by 2. Is it clear? Let's take another example. Let's say 2 upon 5 plus 3 upon 5. Here also both the denominator are same. So we have to just add numerator and write denominator as it is. 2 plus 3, 5. Now as you can see, 5 upon 5, that is both are coming in the table of 5. That is 1's a. So 1 upon 1 is 1. So your answer is 1. Is it simple? So please practice this. 2 upon 7 plus 5 upon 7 and 1 upon 6 plus 3 upon 6. You have to find addition for both the fraction. Okay? Now let's study type 2. When your denominator of fraction are not same. In that you have three cases. Case 1. Case 1. When denominator are not same. For example, you have given 1 upon 3 plus 2 upon 5. So in this example, one of the denominator is 3 and one of the denominator is 5. So what to do in such case? You cannot directly write the denominator as 3 or 5. You have to make both the denominator same. Just remember this, the golden rule for adding fraction where denominator are not same. In first step, you have to always make this denominator same. For adding fraction easily, you have to make this denominator same. And how to make that denominator same? You have to look for both the tables, in the table of 3 as well as in the table of 5. Is there any common number which coming in the both the table? 3 5s are 15 and 5 3s are 15. So in step 1, we have to make denominator of both the terms same. So for this particular term, we have to multiply this entire term by 5. That is 1 into 5 and 3 into 5. As I have explained in part 1, if we are multiplying any number with denominator, we have to compulsory multiply that number with numerator. Okay? So 1 into 5, 3 into 5. 1 5 is a 5 and 3 5 is a 15. Similarly, to make this number 15, we have to multiply numerator as well as denominator with 3. So 2 into 3 divided by 5 into 3, which becomes 2 3 is a 6 and 5 3 is a 15. Now as you can see, both the denominators are same. That is, for 1 by 3 we have 5 by 15, and for 2 by 5 we have 6 by 15. Now as we have already learned in type 1, if denominator of the fraction are same, we have to write denominator as it is and we have to just add their numerator. So 5 plus 6, 11. So does this 11 by 15 have simplest form? No, because neither of numerator or denominator are coming in the same table. So your answer is 11 by 15. Is it clear, student? When your denominator is not same, in which we have learned case 1, when both the denominator are not same and neither of them are coming in each other table. Okay? In case 1, denominator are not same and neither of denominator are coming in each of the table. Is it clear, students? So for 1 by 3 plus 2 by 5, we have answer 11 by 15. Okay? Now let's take another example for type 2 case 1. Let's say 3 by 5 plus 2 by 7. As you can see here, both the denominator are different and neither of these denominator are coming in each table. In the table of 5, 7 is not coming. In the table of 7, 5 is not coming. So as we have learned in example 1, in step 1 we have to make both the denominator same, and for doing that we have to see in the table of 5 and 7 whether some number are common or not. Yes, there is a one number, 35. 5 7 is a 35 and 7 5 is a 35. So we have to make both the denominator same by multiplying this term with 7 and by multiplying this term with 5. In step 1, we have to multiply this term with 7. 3 into 7 and 5 into 7, which becomes 3 7s are 21 and 5 7s are 35. And for this term, we have to multiply numerator and denominator with 5 because we have to make denominator same. And how to make denominator same? By looking both the table, in both the tables some common number are there or not. In the table of 5 and in the table of 7, there is a common term, 35. That's why we are multiplying this term with 7 and this term with 5. So it will become 2 into 5, 10, and 7 into 5, 35. So now the denominator are same. So we have to add both the fraction. So for 3 by 5 we get 21 by 35. And for 2 by 7 we have get 10 upon 35. As we have learned in type 1, the denominator are same. We have to just add its numerator. So 21 plus 10, 31 divided by 35. Okay, so your answer is 31 by 35. Is it clear, student? Okay, student, so this is the case 2 of type 2, where your denominator are not same. Let's say 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 4. Here both the denominator are different. But as you can see, one of the denominator is coming in the table of another denominator. 4 is coming in the denominator of 2, isn't it? So as we have learned in type 1, type 2, while adding the fraction, we have to make both the denominator same. For doing the fraction, both the denominator should be same. So to make both the denominator same, we have to just multiply this side with 2, isn't it? Because here already we have 4, and 4 is coming in the table of 2. So we have to just make this side, this denominator 4. So how to make it 4? Just multiply this term with 2. So 1 into 2 plus 2 into 2, that is 2 upon 4. We have already 1 upon 4, and for 1 by 2 we get 2 upon 4. So both the denominator are same. So we have to just add 2 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4. As you can see here, both the denominator are same. So now we can directly add its numerator. So your answer will be 2 plus 1, 3 upon 4. Is it simple? Let's take another example. If you have some 2 upon 3 plus 3 upon 9. In this example, as you can see, 9 is coming in the table of 3. So for making both the denominators same, so how to make both the denominators same? In the table of 3, is 9 is coming? Yes, 3 threes are 9. So we have to just multiply this side by 3. So 2 into 3 divided by 3 into 3. 2 threes are 6 and 3 threes are 9. So here is denominator 9, and here also the denominator is 9. So we have to add now. For 2 by 3 we get 6 by 9. 6 by 9 plus 3 by 9. Here you can see both the denominators are same. So we have to just add its numerator. 6 plus 3, 9. And denominator remains same, 9. And 9 upon 9 is 1. 9 ones are 1. 9 ones are 1. So your answer is 1. In this way, you can add fraction where denominator are not same and one of the denominator is coming in the table of another denominator. So in such a case, we have to just multiply only one fraction with a particular number. Okay? Is it simple? Okay, students, now the third type is addition with the whole number. If you have given a number like this, 5 plus 1 upon 8, okay, where one number is whole number and another number is fraction. So in such a case, how to add this number? You have to make this whole number as a fraction. If you have given any whole number, say 3, how to make it a fraction? You simply divide that number by 1. If you have a whole number, to make it fraction, you have to just divide it by 1. Because if we divide any number by 1, its value remain the same. In our case, if we want to make this 5 as a fraction, we can write it as 5 divided by 1 plus 1 divided by 8. Simple. We have made this whole number as a fraction. And now we can add this fraction by method or type 2, where your denominator are not same. But as you can see, this is the type 2, case 2, where one of the denominator is coming in the other denominator. It is coming in the table of 1, 1 8's up. So we have to simply multiply this term with 8. So 5 8's up upon 1 8's up. 5 8's up 40 and 1 8's up 8. So for 5 divided by 1, we have 40 divided by 8. 40 divided by 8 plus 1 divided by 8. As you can see, both the denominators are same. So we can simply add its numerator. 40 plus 1 is 41 divided by 8. So in this way, we can add a whole number with fraction. We have to just make a whole number a fraction. And how to make it fraction? By dividing it by 1. And while we dividing it by 1, it becomes fraction. And we have already learned how to add fraction where denominator are different. We have to apply that step and we get the answer. Let's take another example. If we have term 3 plus 1 upon 4. So first we have to make these 3 a fraction. So how to make a 3 a fraction? We have to divide it by 1. So 3 divided by 1 plus 1 divided by 4. As you can see here, we have made this 3 as a fraction. And for this addition, these both the denominator are different. So we have to make it same. So in the table of 1, the 4 is coming or not? Yes, it is coming. 1 4's up. So we have to just multiply this term with 4. That is 3 into 4 divided by 1 into 4. It becomes 12 upon 4. So for the value of 3 by 1, we get 12 by 4. So 12 by 4 plus 1 by 4. Here as you can see, both the denominator are same. So we have to just add its numerator. That is 12 plus 1 is 13 divided by 4. So your answer is 13 by 4. In a such a way, you can add a whole number with a fraction. Okay? Okay, students. So the last type is type 4. That is addition of mixed fraction. Let's take a 2 example so you can easily understand how to add mixed fraction. It is very simple. You have to just convert this mixed fraction into fraction. And we have already learned conversion. How to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. Let's see. If we have a mixed fraction 1 of 1 by 2. How to read a mixed fraction? 1 of 1 by 2, 3 of 1 by 2, 3 of 2 by 5, 1 of 2 by 3. In this way, you can read a mixed fraction. So converting this mixed fraction, that is 1 of 1 by 2, we have to first multiply denominator with whole number. So 2 ones are 2. In step 1, we have to multiply denominator with whole number. 2 ones are 2. Now, we have to add this result with numerator. In step 2, we have to add this result with numerator. That is 2 plus 1. It becomes 3. And that 3 we have to write in step 3 as a numerator and denominator remains same. That is 2. Similarly, for this mixed fraction, we got 3 by 2. For this mixed fraction, we have to, let's see, in step 1, we have multiplied 2, 3, 6. We have to add this result with numerator in step 2. 6 plus 1, 7. And in step 3, we have to write 7 as numerator and its denominator remain same. So for this mixed fraction, we got 3 by 2 plus for this mixed fraction we got 7 by 2. As you can see, both the denominator are same. So we can simply add its numerator. So 3 plus 7 is 10 upon 2. Now we have to see whether the simplest form of this fraction is possible or not. And how to see that? We have to see either of numerator or denominator are coming in the same table or not. Yes, 10 is coming in the table of 2. And 2 is coming in the table of 2. 2 5s are 10 and 2 1s are 10. That is 5 upon 1. Or you can simply write as 5. As we have learned in the previous example, any number divided by 1, it's a number itself. Okay? So, in this way, you can add a mixed fraction where denominator are same. Now, what to do when denominator are not same? It is again simple. We have to first convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. Let's say 5 into 3, 15 plus 2, 17. That is 17 by 5. And for this, 3 ones are 3, 3. 3 ones are 3 plus 2. 3 plus 2 become 5. So for this mixed fraction, the conversion is 5 by 3. So we have to add this. As you can see, both the denominator are different. One is 5, one is 3. So how to add? We have already learned that. We have to see in both the table, either of number is common or not. In the table of 5, 3 is coming? No. In the table of 3, 5 is coming? No. So, in both the tables, some common number are there or not? Yes. 3, 5s are 15 and 5, 3s are 15. So, for this term, we have to multiply numerator and denominator by 3. Why 3? Because we have to make this 5, 15. So, 17 multiplied by 3 and 5 multiplied by 3. So it becomes 51 divided by 15. And for this, we have to multiply denominator and numerator with 5. Why 5? Because we have to make this denominator 15. So 5 into 5 plus 3 into 5. It becomes 25 upon 15. So for value of 17 by 5, we got 51 by 15, and for value of 5 by 3 we got 25 by 15. Now as you can see, both the denominator are same. We simply add this numerator. So the 51 plus 25 become 76 upon 15. Okay, in this way you can add a mixed fraction. With this, we have done with the addition of fraction. In next video, we will learn about subtraction of fraction. Okay?